So, let's start this video what every YouTuber does when they're about to tell us something really personal and touching. Now, that's done. So, hi, hello, what's up, and so on. I have to first say sorry about a few things. If you hear any background noises, it's my boyfriend is playing some games. Light here is really poor. I don't have my light box with me, so we have to deal with this one. What I was going to tell you today, you have seen the campaign #MeToo. You have seen that all over the internet for quite a while. I was planning to make this video for a while, but I just didn't have that much courage to do it. But when I saw other women talking about their experience about this issue and this thing, I just thought that I would want to say my story. I'm not going to go any details about this thing. I'm not going to leak any personal information about this boy. Of course not, because I just want to forget that one and move on with my life. I was 18 years old. I was soon going to turn 16. What? Mass. I was 18 years old and I was turning 19 years old. Yes, 19. It was almost 3 years ago when this thing happened to me. I have been known this guy for 4 years, and out of those 4 years we dated for a couple of years, and our relationship, it was not perfect, but I'm not here to judge on that. So it was one morning on the spring and I was with his house. A little bit hard to talk on this, like I have only talked about this thing with some of my friends. My mother knows, my sister knows, but my father definitely doesn't know. It was one morning and we were waking up, and I know he had been trying to get me do something that I have never ever been done before. He really really wanted to put it in my put it in my butthole, yeah, basically. So never done that. So I was saying to him that I don't want to. I said many, many, many times that I don't want to. We were, yeah, on the bed. I was facing my back on him. I said many, many times that I don't want to. Definitely, I don't want to. He just did it. He just did it. I will always remember what he said when I said to him that I don't want to. It hurts. He told me that, "Shh, you're a big girl. You can do it. You can handle it." Oh, a little bit disgusted by even saying that. On that time, I was not discovered with the cancer. I was still doing boxing occasionally, and like later on, I have been asked by my friends that why you didn't do anything, like why you didn't do anything, but I really saw that I loved this guy. I cared about him, of course, I cared about him. I never saw that he would do something like that on me. Like my friends were saying, "Why you didn't hit him? Why you didn't hit him?" That doesn't mean because my hobby is boxing. That doesn't mean that I'm ready to punch like every single living thing that's on my way. That doesn't work like that. So And of course, I can't hit those people who I care about. Doesn't that make sense? I remember when it was over, I just ran straight into the bathroom and I just sat there and cried. I can tell that I was bleeding and it fucking hurt so much. I kind of realized like later on that I had been thinking about this incident, that he realized that what he had done to me, and he tried to just put it under the rug. Basically, he told me that yeah, I will make your next time when we do this, that it will be way better and it will be your first time doing this and something like that. But yeah, well, we stayed together, but yeah, we broke up for another reasons. For 2 years I carried this by myself. I didn't talk to anybody about this. I told my friend. I clearly remember that time when I went to my friend's house and I was shaking. Even after 2 years, I was still shaking when I told her, and I was crying hysterically. I couldn't stop crying. I just hope that this person, if you are watching this video, you know who you are and what you did to me. I kind of want to say that I wish that I never met you, but I kind of want to say thank you, because if I haven't met such a manipulative person early on in my life, I'm not that much blue-eyed anymore, and I have been growing up and realizing things. So I kind of want to say thank you, but also not. I won't be pressing any charges because it's 2 years over, almost 3 years old thing. So, and I don't want to see this person ever again in my life. I hope that you have realized what you have done and fucking stop doing it, because it really fucked me up inside. To all of you who have been raped or sexually assaulted any other way, I know it will be hard, but you definitely have to talk with somebody about that. Time will heal. Most cases I would like to just go and press the charges if you want justice. I believe that justice on my part, it's over. It's over. I won't be getting any justice out of this. Okay, so that kind of like lighthearted video this time. But hey, thank you so much for watching and being here with me. Remember to like, share, subscribe to my channel, and yeah, I hope that I will see you on the next video. Bye bye.